Money, motherfucker, get money.
Get money.
Let's get money, motherfucker, get money. Get money, motherfucker, get money.
You know the drill, cause we up for the kill. Got a five-star bitch.
Welcome back to another episode of Rose and Gold, and I'm your host, Black King Sebastian, and this is my lovely co-host, Dr. Ross.
Hello, everyone.
Dr. Ross, would you like to explain where we're at right now?
Well, we're here in Dallas, Texas. It's really pretty. You see the people on the scooters, the people with broken legs, the people doing their thing. We're in the center of Dallas, Texas. Black King Sebastian is out here getting the ladies.
On to our first hot topic, the ASAP Rocky, if you guys didn't hear, he went to Sweden and he officially got attacked by these two people. They just walked up to him and straight hit his bodyguard. But first, to ASAP Rocky, all I gotta say to you is, why are you out walking on the streets and not up in your own Lamborghini up in there? But Dr. Ross, what do you have to say about our next hot topic?
On to our next hot topic. So we will place in a clip for what Sebastian said, and then we're gonna place in a clip for what I'm about to say.
Lalo suka at ASAP Rocky.
ASAP fucking Rocky dar o ham.
So, Future's bodyguard, that guy was looking so dumb. He was just walking on the street like how we are now, and he got attacked by so many random guys. Like, they hit him on the side of the head with earbuds. First of all, Future, you need to get your bodyguard some training, some martial arts training, because that guy got messed up. He's really big, but he got attacked by some small people, and that is really, really messed up for Future.
Future's guy, Future's bodyguard, Future's bodyguard.
Mama had all the hard talk, you know. Got spat. No way. Moving mad. Yo, check Future though. Mama took a back seat, you know. Mama's thinking, nah, fuck
that.
Wild,
man.
I ain't fucking with these UK niggas, man.
They UK niggas, man. They don't fuck about.
Hopefully he's okay. Hopefully that's not good. On to the next hot topic. Nicole Murphy, Eddie Murphy's ex-wife, is scandalous. I forgot the name of the guy that she was cheating on, but I'm going to put it right here on the screen. He, first of all, should not be cheating with other girls. His wife, you need to lose some weight. You need to get yourself back together. You need to show him that he is losing out on... He's losing out by going and cheating with all these other girls, because he keeps doing it over and over, and you don't deserve this.
Look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out when I walk in the spot. Yeah, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants, and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it, show it. I'm sexy and I know it. Sexy and I know it.
Because you're just staying at home with the kids and getting a little bigger, And he's going out and basically saying that it's a family friends with Nicole Murphy and over here kissing. That's not family friends unless that's what all family friends do. They just make out like that. But
so guys, before we end it off, to the Mary Kay, you've had 50 hard years of work doing your makeup industry and all that stuff. But now your sons and your family, they now have control of the business. But we're just here at the Omni Hotel and you're hosting a 50th anniversary Cadillac giveaway. And someone's gonna come out with the pink Cadillac, motherfuckers. But before we go off, Kylie Jenner, that's for you. And you're a very smart and intelligent woman.
You smart.
I don't even know where you're sitting at. Like.
He's right there.
Yeah, the glasses, there you go. All right.
And I will read a quote for you, Miss Jenner. I shall read a quote by a great man, Nelson Mandela. It is better to lead from behind and put others in front, especially when you celebrate victory when nice things occur. And that was a quote for you, Miss Jenner. Dr. Ross, do you have anything else to say?
Well, this is all for the Hot Topics. I know it's really, really short today, but Black Miss Smash and I, we're out.
We out, motherfuckers.